designer.
Welcome to my channel about product design. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. In this episode, we're going to take a look at cutting out and turning the main body on a lathe. I was able to have a custom octagonal solar panel built to my specification for the prototype. The main body of the solar charger is built out of a material called Ren. It's a tooling foam. It's got high density, good durability, no grain, perfect for model building. I have a paper pattern in the shape of the octagon that I want. I apply some spray mount to it and then I place it onto my Ren foam. I'm trimming off the excess paper here and I'm just setting the depth. I'm going to take that over to the bandsaw and I'm going to cut a little slab to the thickness that I want, and that's going to get me my blank. The basic part here is just cut out. I'm cutting on the outside of the lines, of course. I'm going to take it over to the sander and we're going to sand to the lines and get the part exactly to the size that we want. So over at the sander, I'm going to try to sand right to that line and get each edge of the octagon the exact same size. So I go through, I measure each one, and I find one that's a little bit shorter. So I'm going to sand that one just a hair more to make it the same length as the other ones. So I'm pretty happy with that. And so now it's time to get this guy onto the lathe and turn it into a ring for the main body. So in order to get this guy turning on the lathe relatively round, we need to find the center point of the part that we just made, and we do that by connecting across and finding the midpoint, and we're going to drill a tiny little pilot hole on the drill press here to mark that point. So this is just a little pilot hole to guide the Forstner bit that we're going to use here. It's about a 45 millimeter diameter bit, and that's going to give us a bigger hole to mount it into the Novichok on the lathe. Now, ideally, I should have clamped the piece down and left it and then just swapped the drill bits so I could get the center perfect. I didn't do that. I've got to kind of eyeball the middle of the Forstner bit to drill out my hole. There's the part with a nice inside hole that the Novichok from the lathe can grab onto so we can turn this thing into a ring. So here you see the part chucked up on the Novichok on the lathe, and I'm just starting to remove some of the inside material so we can start to turn this into a ring. Here I'm making a little concave section on the outside of the ring where we can wrap a cable around for a little bit of cable management. We're going to sand that outside ring, and we're going to do that while the part's on the lathe. I mean, why not get the machine to do the work for us? It's so much easier than doing it by hand. So I'm using about a 220 grit wet dry sandpaper here just to sand that groove really nice and smooth. I probably end up finishing it with like a 320 grit sandpaper. There's no need to go any farther than that since it's ultimately going to get painted anyway. We just want to get it nice and smooth and have a nice finish on it. Here I'm hogging out a little bit more of the inside of the ring just to thin out the material before I get a parting tool and remove it. So here I'm going to use a parting tool, and you'll see me, I'm going to start to cut through the material. There it goes. And I'm going to separate the two parts here and we're going to get our ring part. Next, I need to make a styrene base plate, and we're going to essentially do this in the same way. We're going to use our paper template shaped in the shape of an octagon. We're going to attach this over a sheet of styrene. We're going to cut and score it so that we can get this styrene to the right shape. It's pretty simple. We're just going to break off the pieces at the score line. It works pretty easy. Let's do a quick test with the solar panel to see how it fits on the octagon. It's looking pretty good. Here, let's place a pedal in there so we can get a reference and have an idea of what we're going to be doing. I mark off the space that we're going to need to glue on the pedals a little bit later. So it's probably about 4 or 5 millimeters, and I'm going around marking on the outside, creating that offset, in essence, where the solar panel is going to line up, and then the solar pedals are going to fill it on. We're going to do another quick test. Things are looking pretty good. Next up, we're going to paint. We're going to paint the ring that we made in this episode and the laser cut plastic parts from the last episode. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. I hope that you check out and enjoy some of the other videos that I have. Don't forget to like and subscribe.